Nobody really.
I'm on the big screen. I took a big swing out of life. I'm doing big things in my life. I deserve 6 rings like a mic. I've got a no sleep. I remember when it was the nosebleeds. Now they captured the fashion from flow seats. I'm a whole king.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you own, we own it.
Ooh, it's trouble in paradise. So let's parachute where the air's nice. And let's risk it all on the paradise. But she just wanna make sure her hair's nice. That's fair, right? I just fell in love with a prima donna. The 2023 Madonna. I mean, your honor. I was minding my business until she gave me complete nirvana.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you own, we own it.
From the host of Super Bowl 50 back in February of 2016, there's a look at the home of the 49ers, Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara. Today, after a crazy opening weekend, it's on to week two, and we've got a good one here between the Seattle Seahawks and the San Francisco 49ers. Two teams here fresh off week one victories. Who can keep it going as we're underway on EA Sports? And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Second round pick, Kenneth Walker. And he'll manage to pick up about four. It's second down. The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. They'll fake the handoff. Now Smith. Going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
So many times we see teams go on the road and want to lean on their running game, but this crew just announced they're going to try and air it out and make hay downfield.
This defense looking for an early stop. This is third down and six. On third down, here's Walker across the 30 to the 31-yard line. On fourth down, Smith. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And this defense delivers a turnover on downs on the very first drive of the afternoon. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll bring a receiver in motion right. Purdy now to throw off the play action. Rolling to his right. And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away.
I'll give them credit winning that first snap and forcing an incompletion. They're hoping that'll deflate the offense a little bit if they took the field charged up after taking over after a turnover.
Line of scrimmage, the 31, as they line up, second and 10. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. And he works his way free all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone. The Niners have the first down on a gain of 11.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, it shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down, otherwise it's going to be a long afternoon.
They go play action here, Purdy. This one caught by Kittle. And the 49ers are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. McCaffrey is going to go backwards. He'll lose yardage back to the 5. That's going to go as a loss of 1 on first down.
An interesting and intriguing decision there defensively because they kept extra DBs on the field despite seeing the multiple tight end look that came out for the offense.
I thought they were going to switch out of it. I didn't know if they felt they didn't have time or what the case was.
Well, in any event, the extra speed allowed for great penetration as they stuffed that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Again, McCaffrey. And the hole closes quickly here. He can fight only to about the 4. The second down play, not much better than the first. Just a gain of 1 there. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on 3rd, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that 2nd down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4 down territory.
They'll look to throw on 3rd and goal. Touchdown, 49ers! Christian McCaffrey, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the 49ers are on the board first here this afternoon. Point after here coming up. And the 49ers grab a 7-0 lead. Kick this one away, and off it goes. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
Early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game. But I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice. But at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
Now a deep ball there on 2nd down, but it'll wind up incomplete.
Against a team coming off a win, just as your team did the previous week, you talk about being physical all game long. Sometimes being physical is just being on the spot and helping force the incompletion.
Heavy set out there on 3rd and 1. They'll try and run this one right up the gun. He is going nowhere as he is enveloped behind the line. They'll run for it. It's Walker. And he's not going to get there. Might have even lost a yard. Boy, a curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out, and that will force a turnover on downs. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets it down to the 30 there. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and 7. Well, this defense for the Seahawks, terrific last week in the season-opening victory.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week, because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
Well, he certainly did a nice job improvising there, extending the play, hoping someone would come open downfield, but they never did.
In danger of squandering their great field position as they come up on a 3rd and 7. They'll send a receiver here in motion right. Purdy with it on 3rd and long. He'll buy some time right. Got his target, Samuel. And out of bounds right around the 20. His first catch there, good for 10 yards and a first down.
The Niners at 1-0 on the year following the win in week 1. And they were able to get that road victory in the opener. Now they look to get to 2-0 in front of the home crowd.
And look, any road win in the NFL, that's huge. But when you do it week 1, that gets you pointed in the right direction and sends notice to the rest of the league that you mean business.
And he just throws this one away. Smart decision here this close to the end zone, and it brings up 2nd down.
This is where good coaching and execution come into play, because down this close, you absolutely don't want to turn it over. Good job keeping that in mind as he escaped, bought time, and decided throwing it away was his best option.
After the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 20. Oh, they're going to run a little pop pass here. And he is out of bounds, looks like right at the 15. A nickel look here for the Seahawks on 3rd down. Purdy. And he's got McCaffrey open. Complete. Touchdown. Christian McCaffrey. Halfway to 100 now with career touchdown number 50. And the Niners lead this now 13-0 here in the opening quarter of the ball game. Extra point right down the middle, and that'll make the score 14-0. The 49ers ready to kick it away, and here we go. Into the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Not only are they in search of their first score, they're in search of their first down in this ball game as they come up 1st and 10. Geno down to throw. Oh, he tries to get it to Metcalf, but it's intercepted. Picked off by Fred Warner. And into the end zone, a pick six for the 49er D as they score the touchdown.
Charles, it is pretty rare that we see a team build this kind of lead in the opening quarter. And, man, they seem to be clicking on all three phases right there. The defense doing its part with a pick six.
And it's absolutely been the definition of a start that you would pick for yourself and for your team, right? And I have a feeling that they just want to stay in this zone. What's truly incredible about this start is they can add on a couple more scores. This one could legitimately be over in the second quarter.
Into the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
Well, CD, you kind of feel like they're in a bit of a danger zone right here, because now you're down three scores, and I know we're in the first half, but the way this offense hasn't been able to generate anything, you feel like they probably need to get something going on this drive, right?
Yeah, and sometimes I overuse that this is an important possession, but I think this has to be the possession where they come up with an answer, because only a few teams in league history have ever come back from a four-score deficit. And if they don't score here, that's what they could be facing the next time they get the ball.
To throw again on second down. Smith being chased out left. And it's intercepted. Picked up by Talanoa Hufanga. And the 49ers are going to take possession of the football.
Well, I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy, and can he step into a throw? And when you can't do... Oftentimes, interceptions result.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Now a give, right side McCaffrey. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Chase 21-0, our score after one. Now on second and 13, Purdy looking for the out route. He's got it, complete to Kittle. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line.
A lot of tight ends just use their size and their strength, try to occupy some space and kind of body people away and catch the football. But not this guy. He's a refined route runner. Makes me wonder if he took some dance classes in his background with his footwork.
And he's able to pick up the first down here before he goes down at the 26.
So it's pretty simple, partner. You pick up a turnover, set you up in excellent field position. The last thing you want to do is go three and out in this spot.
Yeah, they would have had to settle for a field goal attempt, but now they keep those touchdown hopes alive.
Purdy's throw pulled in by Kittle. And they've got this down to about the 12-yard line. A nice throw right there. And Charles, this is game number two in the NFL for this young rookie. His guy's getting the victory last week, and he played pretty well by most accounts. Curious, what did you see?
I saw something similar to what you described, Brandon, because I saw a guy who looked the part, a guy who was in command, not just with the touchdown passes, but definitely looked to be in control of the offense as well.
And you have.
And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line. It'll only be a loss of a couple, but the pressure gets home on first down.
Well, that's what they have to do more of defensively. Not just getting sacks, but they have to keep getting in his face. Not let him get his feet set and deliver. He's been carving them up previously.
Yeah, already has a couple of touchdown passes. About time they put a few grass stains on that jersey.
Now, following the sack, they'll come up here on a second down and 12. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And he'll be taken down here at about the 11. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2-yard gain. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
Here's Purdy. Flushed out right. Right side, and he finds Gray. And he's brought down. They scored touchdowns on drives one and two, and now they're trying to make it a perfect 3-for-3 to start. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And across the goal line, into the end zone, touchdown 49ers. Christian McCaffrey on his way to a monster game. 3 first-half touchdowns. And the 49ers are able to add on to their first-half lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 28-0. The 49ers ready to kick it away, and here we go. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They're still in search of an initial first down as they come up here first and 10. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Throwing now is Geno. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Smith, an incomplete pass on first down. Now it's second and 10.
19 tight.
Now Geno. He lets it fly for Lockett. It got his man complete. And way in, touchdown Seattle. Tyler Lockett, 63 yards. And the Seahawks get a bit closer. Good start to the season for him. He had the touchdown last week in the opener and a second one in week two now.
How about the pace he's already established, right? Not sure he can keep it up for an entire season, but don't burst the bubble because he thinks that he can.
Do guys go into a season with a goal for touchdown scored or yardage? What do you think?
I think every single one of the guys who's going to touch the football, they all have those types of goals. They all have those types of thoughts. And then they just have to see how the season unfolds if they can stay with it.
Unfolding so far so good for him.
This will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Right now, everything they touch turns to gold. This is their fourth possession. Touchdowns on their first three possessions. I mean, this defense, they can't seem to stop them. It's like they're on skates.
Great analogy, Brandon, because they are pushing them back and winning everything at the line of scrimmage. They've just been laying down tracks towards the opposite end zone. So to themselves, all they're saying is, if we don't make a mistake, there's no way they can stop us.
So the opening play of the drive goes backwards. Now they'll come up on second and 12.
Purdy looking to throw. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. So the screen good for only two. Now it's third down. And we've hit the two-minute mark in this first half of action. A reminder coming up at halftime. We'll head to Orlando. Standing by there, Jonathan Coachman. He'll have stats and scores from around the NFL in this second week of the regular season. Right where this set of downs started, they need a full 10 here to pick up the first down and move the chains. Third down, here's McCaffrey. And he's going to be brought down short of the first at about the 31-yard line. They'll get six there on the run, but it brings up fourth down. Now the Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On fourth down, the Niners trot out Mitch Wishnowsky to punt the football. Back deep for the Seahawks, Tyler Lockett. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And it'll be Seahawk football first and 10. Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. A strong showing their last time out. They scored the touchdown, but Charles, they look up and they're still down double digits, so you feel like just to keep pace, this drive probably needs to end in the end zone as well.
Yeah, and I think the best move for them is to not worry about how far they are down on the scoreboard, but to just remember the last drive and how it ended. Go ahead and try and repeat that. Then you can look at the scoreboard and see where this game is.
A leap and he's got it! He got it! And he'll be hauled down at about the 30-yard line. On first down, they'll go to the ground attack. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. The last run got six, now second and four. Now it's Smith. Forced out to his left. That is taken in by the tight end Fant. And out of bounds all the way down at the three. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
That's a big league job there of getting out of the pocket, not panicking, and just buying himself some time. Then he made a good, accurate throw to set up first and goal.
This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Here's Walker. And he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the two-yard line. From the two now, second and goal. From the gun, here's Smith sliding out of the pocket. And he'll just throw this one over in the way of the security crew. Incomplete here.
I'm really liking what I'm seeing from this defense because their coverage has been playing at a shutdown level so far. Even backed up late, they're forcing incompletions and fighting to keep them out of the end zone as the first half winds down.
Motion left, the tight end. They'll try and run, Walker. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. Kenneth Walker in the final seconds of the first half. And the Seahawks are able to cut into this lead in the final seconds of the first half. Extra point up and through by Myers. And that cuts this lead down to 13. So still time for the kickoff here. 1 second to go in the half as this one is away. Very short kick. This will be taken by one of the up men.
So we've reached the intermission in what right now is a 13-point game. As we send you cross-country to Orlando, Jonathan Coachman is there and has our EA Sports halftime report. It's the 49ers out in front, and they will get the football first as well as we are back and started in the second half. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. Starting the second half with a run by McCaffrey. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
The first down run got 5. Here's 2nd and 5. Again, they run. Again, it's McCaffrey. And there just continues to be nowhere to run. He's bottled up again at the line of scrimmage. They'll say no gain on the play there, and now it'll be 3rd down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the 3rd quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Now the number 8 rusher in the NFL last season, it's Elijah Mitchell. And this will not be enough. On 3rd and 5, he only gets 3.
Now that was a big-time play by the defense. They as well knew where the first down line was, and they didn't let him get anywhere near it.
Here comes the 49ers punter now, as he'll kick it away for the 2nd time. Play on special teams here. This is going to be down inside the 5, all the way down at the 2-yard line.
And he's got to be fired up about that effort. I don't think he could have walked down and placed it any better than where he ended up putting the football. That was excellent.
Coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. They'll run with Walker to begin the drive. And he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. 2nd down.
Well, they still have time to get him established, but in my estimation, they've got to pick up the urgency here. They've got to get quickly in and out of the huddle and run off a bunch more plays.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Smith. Throw out wide to Walker. And from the 4, they get it to the 8 on a pickup of 4. This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on 3rd down. Out of the gun, Walker with it. And he'll be tackled about 2 yards shy of the line to gain. A 1-yard pickup leads to 4th down. Here we go on 4th. Smith. And he'll be taken down, but he does have 1st down yardage. Work to do here to avoid falling to 1-1, but this is 1st and 10 right now. To throw is Smith. Steps away to his left. He'll get just 1 yard on the scramble in 2nd down.
I'm not quite sure what he thought he saw there, but the reality was certainly a much different picture than what he anticipated. And give credit to the defense. They were down on the flash when he broke out of there, and they forced him out with almost nothing to show for his efforts.
Throwing again on 2nd down. Smith, they'll roll him out right. He completes this to Walker, and he almost gets this to the 30, taken down about 1 yard shy. They'll fake it. Now Smith. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. It's caught inside the 25. And all the way end. Touchdown, Seattle. A big play there. 71 yards. And the Seahawks have got it back to within a score. That's a score you felt they had to have here in the third quarter to get back in this game.
And you know that there was an emphasis on their side. Hey, we know this. We know where we are. But sometimes that binds you up so much that you try too hard and you don't get the score. A perfect combination of urgency, yet relaxed enough to get it done.
And after the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Set to get this drive underway. Pretty important third quarter drive for them. Momentum has sort of shifted the other direction after that last touchdown as they nurse this small lead. They start on the ground with McCaffrey. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 42 yards rushing for him now as he's carried it 13 times.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
They're going to run the sweep. It's Samuel. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and eight.
Well, they gave up a few yards there, but all in all, I think it's a pretty nice job defensively against the Jets sweep. If they don't slow him up, he might take it to the house. So they'll take that play every time on the defensive side of the ball.
From the 45 on second down, Purdy, and he slings one that's incomplete.
That incompletion certainly makes this upcoming third down a little bit more crucial. They need to find the right play to convert here and maybe start to tamp down a little bit of the momentum the other side is starting to gain.
The slot man in motion right. Purdy will set up to throw it here. Eluding the pressure right. Oh, he'll take a shot from McCaffrey downfield. And that one incomplete. They try to sneak in a deep ball with the clock running down. But to no avail as time will expire on this third quarter of play. Here comes the 49ers punter now. As he's on here to punt it away. And that'll hit in the end zone. Much too much leg there. That'll be a touchback. Into the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense. Their defense accomplished step one of the mission. They forced the punt. Now they'll look to erase that deficit and take a fourth quarter lead. Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Here's Smith. He's got a man complete. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Out of the gun, Smith. He's going to take another shot here. And this ball incomplete.
looked very much to be a catchable ball and could not hang on. Second down coming up. False start there. That will set the offense back 5 yards.
Brandon, the lineman, certainly flinched there before the snap. A good call.
So after the penalty, heading in the wrong direction, second and 15. Smith now to throw. And Walker has it. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 40. The offense on third down, they've only converted once in 4 tries. This is 3rd and 8. Off of play action, here's Smith. He's going to launch this thing way downfield. And he is in for the Seattle touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown of the game, his 3rd on the year. And the Seahawks are an extra point away from taking the lead here in the 4th. The extra point now coming from Myers. And they have taken the lead here in this 4th quarter. After the touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. Returning from his end zone is Ray McCloud. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive. And now they'll look to answer working from behind. And remember, this offense has sputtered, yet to score here in the second half. They'll need to change that here. That's to about the 28. Second down coming up.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. They stay on the ground. McCaffrey again. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
As big of a play as we've had in this one so far. This is 3rd and 3. Slot man moves right. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he won't be close to a first down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain there, and it leads to a 4th down. They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL. And he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time. So make sure you get in shape.
Purdy, big 4th down play. And this pass caught by Gray. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. A gutsy call. Turns out to be a good one, though. 1st down on a pickup of 11. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. 1st down, and he gets out of bounds.
Yeah, you have to like the play calling because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
Here's Purdy on 1st and 10. Pressure comes. He's taken down by the Seahawk defense. Darryl Taylor got in there to drop him.
The lessons will continue, but this rookie, he's got to learn how to read situations just a little bit better. That far behind the line, he's got to find a way to get rid of the football and not take the sack, whether it's with his legs or just throwing it away.
They'll send a receiver in motion to the right. Throwing on 2nd and long.
Purdy looking for the crossing receiver, and he's got him. It's Samuel. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. Possibly a turning point. Big play coming. This is third and long. Now Purdy rolling to his right. And that's going to be incomplete. The contact there enough to jar that ball free, and it brings up fourth down.
With that incompletion, reality is staring them right in the face. This entire game is down to the next snap.
Fourth down try. Here's Purdy. Oh, he forces one there. It's a potential dagger as it's intercepted. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Well, dare I say it, it's kind of quid pro quo. Both defenses now with an interception return for a touchdown.
Your vocabulary, sir. Well done.
Still an important piece of business to take care of, the extra point. And with that, the lead is up to 8. So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Here's McLeod from his end zone. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. The 49er offense set to get this drive underway. Remember, they were just out here a moment ago through the pick 6, so we'll see if they can take better care of the football this go around.
Yeah, and sometimes, partner, I think it's almost better that you just throw the pick 6 and you come right back out on the field. You're not over on the sidelines dwelling for it for very long. You're not hearing everyone say, oh, hey, you'll get them next time. Hey, don't worry about it. All that stuff just goes right out the window. You're right back out on the field with a chance to atone.
Now left side, a completion to his tight end. Finding space at the 40. And they've got it well across midfield down to the 40 before it's all said and done. So the big play moves him all the way across midfield to the 40 now for 1st and 10. Purdy to throw. Able to find Gray here. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. 25 yards that time. Here's Purdy. And this will be caught. Touchdown. So in the final minute here, now a 2-point conversion will tie the game.
The touchdown's massive, but now they've got to have 2 to possibly take this to overtime.
Seahawks going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. The late touchdown was only half the battle. Now they need the 2-point conversion to tie the ball game. They'll try and run it in, and he will get in. The 2-point conversion is good, and we may be on our way to overtime. So here comes the kickoff now, all even here in this fourth quarter. coming to the line here to begin their next drive, the Seahawks offense.
And Charles, obviously not much time left. I'm curious to see if there's enough for them to get into field goal range and try to win this thing.
And part of you and I both know the safe calls to kneel and just take it into overtime. But it's also very tough to pass up a chance to win it right now as well. But remember, if you do attempt that, it's got to be a big play downfield and still leave yourself enough time to get your field goal unit out there and kick for the win.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. Now Smith going for Metcalf on the deep ball, and this is caught inside the five, and he's going to get this down in. Inside the five before he's out of bounds. A game-winning field goal would be a chip shot from here. Let's see how they play it on first and goal. Walker now on first and 10. And he's in for the touchdown. And in the final seconds, forget overtime. They've just likely won this thing in regulation.
Well, they move the ball down the field through the air, Charles, and then finally they get the running game involved, and it works to perfection. Touchdown.
And, partner, I kept waiting for that running game to come into play and actually saved it until the very end. Touchdown goes on his stat sheet. But you and I both know, and he knows as well, his teammates airing it out made this a successful drive.
Myers connects on the PAT, and they will take a 7-point lead. The touchdown, here's Myers to boot it away. And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll start things out at the 25. The San Francisco offense ready to start their next drive.
Well, the football changing hands here, and as this offense takes a field, Charles, they'd be fine with more of the same on this upcoming drive. Last time out, they found the end zone for 6.
And they're certainly hoping for more of the same, but the game plan, I doubt it'll just be a carbon copy of the last drive, because I think this offense is ready to break out some new wrinkles and try some new things that might be hidden in their playbook. They want to use that confidence to its advantage, while also keeping the defense from anticipating what's up next.
Back to throw. Now a desperation throw deep downfield.
And oh, that one nearly intercepted. That would have sealed it. Instead, it'll be second down.
So after all of this, it comes down to one final play.
And just think of what it's going to be, because from this distance, you've got to be prepared for everything. Hook and laterals, tip balls, you name it. A lot of laterals after a catch. Just got to be prepared, stay on your feet defensively, and tackle someone.
Purdy with one final shot here. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over.
Well, it took us until the final play, Charles, to officially decide a winner. Although on that last play, they were so backed up, it would have taken a miracle, and they couldn't get that miracle done.
Well, I like how you stayed with it, because we both knew that this had to go down to the last play, and neither side was going to exhale until that play concluded, because we've seen the improbable before. A couple of laterals, maybe some poor defense on the back end. They might have gone all the way to the end zone. In this case, though, it didn't happen. Perhaps next time.
So for the Seahawks, it was a great all-around performance as they come out of this one with the victory. And they'll head back home next week to take on the Atlanta Falcons. Meanwhile, for the 49ers, they'll fall to 1-1. And they'll look to get back on track next week as they travel to Denver to take on the Broncos. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.